Hello guys, today we will see the Excel automation. So first thing we will see how to open an Excel, then we will check about the read cell, how to read a particular cell, then we will see how to read a particular column. After that we will see how to read an entire row, then we will see how to read an entire range or how to read an entire Excel, then we will go for the write Excel, then we will go for how to write a particular cell into Excel. After that we will see how to write a range, and at the last we will see how to merge two Excels. So let's start with the UiPath first. So I will create a new process, that is the Excel automation. So this is my main XML file. Okay, so the first thing is open Excel. So before that I will show you my two Excels, that is, so this is my first Excel file, so which contains the name, email and contact. Okay, so name, there are total three rows and three columns. So first let's see how to open an Excel. So I will drag and drop the Excel activity scope. We have the activity to opening the Excel called as the Excel application scope. So if you click on here, it will open the properties panel. So here you can see if there is a password, we can give a password field also, edit password also. And here we have to directly, we can just give a path, or else we can pass here also. Then we have the option, that is after completion of process, we have to save automatically. So here for the auto save checkbox, create a new file also, we have an option, directly it will create a new file. For example, if you want to add a new sheet or new file, so if you check this, it will directly add to that file. Okay, so let's open the first Excel. So I'll click here. So this is the very fast process. So for that, let's put a delay. I will give a 7 second delay here, so we can able to see is running or not. So yeah, so our Excel file is opening. So it will wait for 7 seconds and automatically it get closed. So this is our opening an Excel. So second thing now is the read cell activity. So okay, for reading a particular cell in Excel, we have the directly option called as the read cell. We will drag and drop that activity. So here you can see the sheet 1. Here if you want to read from sheet 2, you just change the name to sheet 1 to sheet 2. Which particular cell you want to read? I want to read A2, which is my name, that is John. So to store this value, we have to give one output variable here. So I will create one variable, that is read cell. Okay, and for displaying our output, we will use a message box. And I will pass that variable here. And let's see. It should give a message box, that is John S. Yes. So this is how we can use the read cell activity. So now third thing is read column. So till that I will disable these activities. So you can right click and disable this activity, or else you can directly use the control T. Okay, so here I will change my comment out name, that is the read cell. So whenever I want to check, it will be easy. So let's see for the read column. So we have the option, that is the read column activity. So I'll drag and drop that read activity column. So again, here you want to pass the sheet name and which column you want to read. So I want to read from A1 up to the N. So I will store this value in a particular variable, that is we read column. Okay, so now if you can see this Excel, this column contains the four rows. So for that we will use the for As you can know, for each is used for iteration mode. So here for each item in my Excel, and I will pass the variable here, that is the read column. And I will simply display and message box, that is item dot to stream. Because if you can see the variable type, here it is the enumerable type. So that's why we have to convert it into to stream. And let's see the output. Name, then John S, then Smith, and then Osho. Okay, so our read column is working fine. So now the next thing is we will check for a read row activity. So till now I will disable this, and for reading a row we have the option, that is the read row. So I will drag and drop that activity here. So as you can see, now again we have to pass the sheet name and which row I want to read. So I will give here A2. From A2 I want to read the entire Excel up to end. So I have to store somewhere, so I will create one variable, that is read row. Here also there are multiple columns and rows, so for that we will take for each activity, for each item in my Excel with a particular row. I will pass the variable here, that is the read row, and simply I will display in message box, that is item dot to stream. So let's run this process. So it should run in the manner, first it will run John S, after that John at the rate email. Yeah, so let me disable this activity. So now we will see the next one, that is the read range. Okay, so for read range activity we have the directly activity, that is read range activity. I will drag and drop that activity here. So as you can see now, here we have to pass the sheet name, and if you give a blank here, then it will read an entire range, entire Excel. So if you want to read from particular column A1 to, for example, C3, so here you can specify that range. So to store this thing, we have to create one variable. So Control K V. Read range. Let's see. Now if you can see, the read range has the data type, that is the data table. Okay, also from here you can change the scope of that particular variable. So I will give you a sequence. Okay, otherwise it will only work up to do. So if you take a sequence, in entire sequence, whenever you want, you can use that read range. So now to reading this one, we have to take a for each activity. For each. So remember one thing, whenever you will use the read range, you will take the activity, that is the for each row activity. Because here there are multiple columns and multiple rows. So here for each activity will not work. Okay, so we will take a for each row activity, and I will pass the variable here, that is read range, and simply I will display a message box, that is row. Okay, which column, particular column I want to display, so I have to put some index dot to string. And let's see, it should give the output John S, then Smith, and then Osho. Okay, so it is working fine. So let me recall again. The our first thing is that is the open Excel, then the read cell for reading a particular cell, then read column. This we use the for each activity. For read row, we will use the for each activity because there is only single row. Here in read range, we use the for each row activity because there are multiple rows and columns. So for that we will use the for each activity. So after that, let's see how to write a particular cell into Excel. Writing a cell, we have the write cell activity. So as you can see the properties here, the sheet name where you want to write a cell, that is the range. Okay, so I will put here, I want to write a contact in front of the John. So that is the C2. It is only applicable for a single cell. Okay, so I will directly pass a contact number here. Save. Save and run. So let's see. So yes, it's written the contact number here. So this is how we can just write a single cell with the help of the write cell activity. Now we will see write range activity also, as well as the merge two Excels. So this both we can see in a single activity. So as I told you, for reading a particular Excel or opening the particular Excel, we have to take the Excel application scope. So I took for the first Excel SX, that is the Excel application scope. Now I want to read a second Excel. So for that second Excel, which contains the name and number. So for that, again, I will take a Excel application scope and I will pass the path here. Okay, so I want to read the entire range. So for that I will take a read range activity. I will pass the output variable v read range 2. And now, so I want to use this variable outside the Excel application scope. Okay, so for that I will change the scope here up to sequence, so I can use now in entire sequence. So now what we have to do, we have to read this entire range and create one sheet here, that is the sheet number 2, and we will write that entire data into sheet 2. So let's see. So let's see how we can do. So here I am reading the range, and now so I will take a write range activity. Okay, so here I have to pass the vread data 2 variable. Okay, so as you can see here, the in properties option, whenever you want to write something, so here we have to change from which cell you want to start, and the sheet name. I will change the sheet name up to, because we will create a, it will automatically create a new sheet and it will write there. And also we have the option, that is the add header or not. So I will click on add header and I will run this process. So this is my first Excel, which had those doesn't have the sheet 2. Yes, now let's see. So now as you can see, okay, here the bot wrote all the values which are present in the sheet 2, which are present in the second sheet, which are present in the second sheet. So we completed all the 8 activities. So thank you guys.